In this video, we will present the satin fill stitch type. Whenever we create a design part, the software automatically chooses the most suitable fill and outline type. This heart symbol is filled with step. Step is mainly used for filling large areas. Satin, on the other hand, is used to fill more narrow areas. Take, for example, this lettering part. It's filled with satin. In general, satin stitch type has needle penetration points at the edges and no stitch points in the middle. Lettering parts are a representative example of satin fill, at least in most cases. Using the available options of object properties, you can customize the satin stitches. If you apply a pattern, you may wish to create wider satin bars. Those look like a satin bar, but they have needle penetration points inside the shape as well. When a pattern is applied, there is an additional option, length. By typing a value, you set the length of the pattern. Additionally, there are some advanced parameters which you can use to adjust the satin stitch. First of all, you can change the density. In this way, you can make satin lighter or thicker. When the option is left unchecked, it is reversed to the default value. The default value may vary according to the selected fabric. Compensation is about the fact that when we embroider a part, then it may shrink a little. Shrinking depends on the fabric, on the tension of the thread, and the speed of the machine. So, you can change the compensation value when you think that the result will pull. Notice that the applied compensation is not visible unless you switch to manual mode. Now, the underlay is a very important factor which also affects embroidery quality. Underlay is practically the stitches that go first and support the stitches that come on top. You can only preview the underlay using slow redraw. For this satin bar, the auto-selected underlay was a double line. If you wish to have a lighter underlay, you may add a single line, for example. Or if you want a heavier underlay, you may select netting. This one adds a double line and then a net before the satin stitches. There are also some underlays to help you build up a plump satin and create sort of a 3D effect. Such underlays add multiple layers of narrow satin lines in order to produce that plump satin bar. Using sequence option, you can manually change the position of the part in the design order. And using remove overlaps, you can enable or disable the automatic filter, which removes overlaps between objects for vector designs. These options are presented in separate videos. Last but not least, keep in mind that in satin you may add multiple direction lines or divides. Directions and divides are also described in detail in a separate video.